is pleased to see you. Ordis has received messages for the...
Oh, the Leverian. It was floundering. You understand? Going under. All that work I put into it, and so few visited, let alone donated. Oh, I don't mean you, of course. I know you're a friend to the Leverian. It just wasn't enough. So when Parvos made me an offer, I thought, oh, why not? Just let it go. Let it all go. I took the deal, Tenno. I shouldn't have, but I did. Oh, if only Dante was still around. Please, you must come see me.
If lost upon the plains outside Cetus, you may derive sustenance from mineral-dense termite droppings, which the Ostrons call Ito-Da.
You may also never form a consonant again, but at least you will not be dead. fresh off the line.
Saddle up.
a large platoon of Grenier Marines stationed here. Leave no one standing.
The Grenier have no honor.
Strike, we have to win this.
Stay focused. There's a heavy unit approaching. My readings indicate an increasingly dense neural network beneath the forest floor. This can only mean one thing. The Silver Grove is nearby. Broken their ranks and they are on the run. Another successful mission. Find extraction.
Little bird tells me that nasty old Nefanyo's got something up his sleeve for the good people of Fortune. But I...
Now, just in case some of you ain't doing all this out of the kindness of your hearts. Coming up next.
Tenno, may I extend an invitation? My latest collection of choice items from the Void is now available for viewing. Barrow Key Tier, at your service. Next time I'll have something you'll want, I'm sure of it.
What do you reckon it's like then, being brain shell? Just dark, I reckon. That visitor, what talks in riddles, she stopped me the other day. Thank me, she did, for that which I am yet to do. I asked her what. She said, we rotten futuristry by pausing a stranger. I suppose that's what I'm doing this moment, isn't it? Oh, ew, I don't like this. I must get back to work. It's like then, being brain shell. Just dark, I reckon. That visitor, what talks in riddles, she stopped me the other day. Thank me, she did, for that which I am yet to do. I asked her what. She said, we rotten futuristry by pausing a stranger. I suppose that's what I'm doing this moment, isn't it? Oh, ew, I don't like this. I must get back to work. What do you reckon it's like then, being brain shell? Just dark, I reckon. in riddles? She stopped me the other day. Think me, she did. For think which I am yet to do. I asked her what. She said, we rotten futuristry by poison a stranger. I suppose that's what I'm doing this moment, isn't it? Oh, I don't like this. I must get back to work. What do you reckon it's like then? Being brain shell. Just dark, I reckon. I suppose that's what I'm doing this moment, isn't it? Oh, I don't like this. I'll just get back to work. What do you reckon it's like then? Being brain shell. Just dark, I reckon.
I can tell you will appreciate what I have today. A pleasure doing business with you, Tenno. Perhaps you'll come to one of my next parties? If you like that, come back next time I'm in the relay. I'll have something extra special for you.
Hello, friend. You find me now amidst the bones of all I am, of the thing that mattered most to me in my too long life. You know, Tarvos Granum, you know the name. He of the gilded hand and gilded tongue. For an age, he has sought what Dante and I had gathered together, our collected treasures. For one such as Granum, there is no such thing as enough. In an age with no appetite for memory, maintaining a shrine to our shared history seemed folly. And so, in a low moment, I signed it all away.
Thank you.
Did I never tell you of Dante? No? I suppose I didn't. I suppose I hadn't the fortitude. The entirety of the Leverian is shaped by the lack of him. Though perhaps only in ways that I can see. Though, by definition, a weapon of war, Dante was, first and foremost, a student of history. And he was my friend. Truthfully, much of the Leverian would not exist were it not for that bold, two-fisted academician's devotion to both myself and the cause of better understanding our history and ourselves. It shames me to think of what he would have to say about what I have done to our shared endeavor. I do not know what possessed me in that moment. I have no need for money, or food, or shelter, or care. Perhaps I merely felt my time was done, that the past had served its use, and me along with it. Whatever the reason, I allowed myself an instant to feel my misery to be greater than my life's purpose. A momentary indulgence that may be paid by every future generation until the sun goes dark. I would give much for my friend to have been here. Dante and I, we tempered each other's unique compulsions. You would have liked Dante, I feel. His end began, as it did for so many souls, with the Entrati family. The patriarch of that benighted family had fallen into decadence and disrepute, his name sullied by controversy and implications of madness. Then an erstwhile associate of mine, a gentleman by the name of Lloyd, a master Entrati's man for more than a lifetime, well, vanished. Lloyd, his master, and his entire lineage, just gone. There were rumors, of course. Master Entrati was known at that time for outlandish claims and questionable science relating to voices he was hearing, I believe. Gods from beyond the veil and whatnot. After the disappearances, Dante, never one to let a good mystery go, insisted on infiltrating the Entrati manse and learning the truth for himself. I, however, being more familiar with the confidential details of Master Entrati's interests, urged him otherwise. I suppose you wonder why I would do such a thing if I believed Master Entrati to be fit for little more than the asylum. Lloyd was, as I said, a dear friend. We spoke often. His last missive to me was a simple one. We end as we began. As a student of history and its occult apocrypha, I know the terrible import of those words. And so I cautioned Dante to remain by my side. He promised to do so, then did otherwise. And I never saw him again. Perhaps I was not so deft at tempering him as he was of me. And that, I suppose, was my first great failing. The parent of this second and most final one. I imagine you surmised why I have summoned you here. To ask that, in the name of whatever friendship we share, to lend your aid to my impossible predicament. To help preserve, not me, not this shadow of a man I once was, but to keep this monument to history alive, so that future generations may learn from it and never repeat our most shameful mistakes. Granum's obsession with that bygone age demands pieces of such. Ironic, really, that one man's interest in history serves only to strip an edifice whose singular purpose was to protect it. But there remains one slim hope: the sourcing of artifacts from places other than the Leverian. Sourced by you at my direction. Help me, friend. Help me, that my one great and final mistake not be the error that turns our collective history and the work of lifetimes to a single miserable use, making a rich man richer.
Operator, a communication awaits your attention. Ordis wonders, why is he here? Ordis supposes everyone has to be somewhere.
Arterial conduits, Albrecht's interlab transport and storage system for high-value goods and materials. If you can get them working, you should be able to find what Drusus needs. And more. Appeared. Hooray! Dock it. Excellent. Look for a conduit with a matching gear. The Mother have captured the dockets you need. Be aware, the Gruzzlings have a particular appetite for dockets. That's it. Protect the conduit and watch out for enemy necromechs. They'll blow the whole apparatus up just to keep you out. To invert the polarization of this conduit's burden. It's working for you now. Preparing your necromech, waiting for you to unlock the transit path. When you hear beeping, you know something explosive is coming your way. Collect your necromech from the dispenser at your convenience. Give them hell. Conduits at the ready, if you can find the right dockets. Activated. Explosive necromechs incoming. Stop them. treat dockets as if they were sugared biscuits. Coming online momentarily. Steady yourself. Who's it? Conduits warming up for transfer. I was able to reverse the conduit's burden. Can you feel the difference? Dignity. Dignity at all times. I'm never alone down here, Tenno. It's always watching. I cannot lie, Tenno. I have always felt nervous in the presence of Warframes. The Orokin twisted people into weapons, and I've seen firsthand the bloody and well-deserved consequences of that act. Dante, though. In his company, I felt no such anxiety. He was warm, earnest, literate, a fellow seeker. To know that he perished in these very halls while I slept is a bitterness to me. Our adversary seeks to muddy our recollection of true history. We will need reliable chronicles more than ever. Warframes cannot speak, as a rule. Their creator decided they should only scream, or roar, or howl. Dante spoke through his writing, and his voice was beautiful. Dante shared the Entrati fascination with bones. I was content to let him explore our old burial vaults and ossuaries, but his request to examine my own replicated skull was a step too far. Otherwise, his manners were impeccable. The gods of writing were always gods of magic, too. Demons and ideas, both bound up in books. Impossible to bind forever, mind you. No matter how all satisfactory, I trust.